That's a gigantic churro, wouldn't you say, my friend? Oh, man, he's a Zen master.
Me voy a ganar 10 kilos en este viaje.
Yo también.
You sound like General Pat. We're gonna take the hill, Bippin.
Castilla La Mancha.
Look at this. Is it good or what?
You're a cheesemaker now.
I need a picture, people.
Yeah, exactly. I've never seen a film like that.
Welcome to Spain, baby.
One, two. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road. Life I love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning our way. And our way is on the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. Life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road.
Stop that.
It's very cool. I need a picture,
there you go,
people.
Baby. Exactly. It's not like we're going anywhere 30 yards down the road.
I'm a tourist, too.
I love being a tourist. Castilla La Mancha.
Viva Castilla La Mancha.
So, no, the thing that impresses me the most is as we're driving through this town was 400 years ago. Hola.
Don't you feel like just running around those fields with like a sword?
A sword? Absolutely.
Don't you?
We could go to Toledo and get a sword.
We should get one.
This is on the same level as St. Peter.
Why are you yelling at me?
Because I'm so excited.
What did I do to you?
We were off and rolling on the Spanish road trip of a lifetime. I was stoked. For me, it was a bit of a homecoming. My family had moved to Madrid when I was in high school, and it was here in Spain that I went through, shall we say, my formative gastronomic years. With my good buddy Mark Bittman of the New York Times, we would do a lap around the Iberian Peninsula, chowing down on the regional cooking.
A blue cheese from here. Wow. Bueno.
And washing it back with the best of the local vino.
Ooh, a nice soft nose. It's just beautiful. Makes you want to drink it.
And that was what this road trip was originally all about. But that all changed. It was at a dinner party where I happened to mention the road trip to my pal Gwyneth Paltrow. The moment GP heard about it, she was in. But now we were a threesome. And since three can be a crowd, we needed a fourth. Enter Claudia Bassols, a knockout Spanish actress who speaks six languages. Claudia would clearly be the perfect road companion for Biddy, whose Spanish was a bit lacking.
Claudia, how do we say, I love the sky?
Me encanta el cielo.
Me encanta el cielo.
El cielo.
El cielo.
Yeah.
El vino.
Yeah, you know that one quite well.
Our road trip dream team was complete. Bittman and I, two food and wine-obsessed fiends, had planned our itinerary accordingly. Our two lovely lady companions had in mind to take in some of the other pleasures of Spanish culture, its history, its art, and its architecture.
Yeah.
A bit of time for some shopping and spa treatments might also be in the works. Our road trip had all the makings of a battle of the sexes, had it not been for the fact that, in truth, both Biddy and I wanted to soak up some Spanish culture.
Is that the old Castile or the new Castile?
Even more significantly, our svelte lady companions, Paltrow and Bassols, had the astonishing appetites of long-haul truck drivers.
Why did they put the French fries in front of me? I can't stop. Yeah.
All four of us met up in Madrid, and we had our first of what would be many, many four-hour wine-soaked dinners. We dined at Celeb Hotspot Casa Lucio, Madrid's uber-famous restaurant where you have to know somebody just to get in before midnight.
You're from Barcelona?
Yes.
You're from Oaxaca?
I am.
No.
I'm from New York.
Born in L.A.?
I'm born in L.A., raised in New York.
You?
Born in New York.
Manhattan.
What about you, Maria?
Born in Seattle.
Our dinner was over by midnight, early by Madrid standards. The very next morning, our road trip of a lifetime was about to begin.
We're at the right place. This is
going to
be a
time.
Long, no, this is the right time. This is going to be a long road trip. What you and I have to do is maintain focus. We got our two friends, Gwyneth and Basols, and they're going to constantly try to distract us from our main objective.
Which is?
Eating.
Eating and understanding the cuisine of the Iberian Peninsula. We cannot give up on this at any time.
You sound like General Patton.
We're going to take the hill, Bippin.
I'm still in bed.
Me too. Do you want some chocolate con churros? Do you like it?
I love it. Are you kidding me? When I was a teenager here, I wanted that every morning.
Oh, really?
Just to add to the artery blockers.
Hola, hombre.
Hola, buenos días.
¿Qué tal?
Muy bien.
Sí, sí, vamos a ver.
Retiraros no manches.
Sí, watch out, baby. Oh, man, he's a Zen master. See, this tuna would never be wasted with mayonnaise and relish on white bread at the local deli.
All olive oil,
garlic, grill, everything done right.
So are you feeling it now, Biddy?
I am totally feeling it.
We're not thinking spa treatments. We're not thinking fancy hotel luxury.
No, we're thinking Ventresca the tuna. Ventresca. We're thinking Barberachos.
Gracias.
Okay.
A vosotros.
Me voy a ganar 10 kilos en este viaje.
Yo también. Podemos hacer una foto de antes y de después.
Look at that one, huh?
That's a beauty.
That's a scorpion. That's a
scorpion fish.
This is the basis of all great soups of fish.
It looks like he's alive.
He is
alive. I don't know what's happening.
That's right.
What is this? Is this some kind of eel?
Take a look, baby.
Oh. Yes, my friend.
That is looking good. That's a 50 or 60 pounder. That's a gigantic churro, wouldn't you say, my friend?
So we're driving to Toledo today. Are you going to drive or is Mark going to drive?
Okay, that's the thing. I'm an amazing city driver. I'm really good. I know how to kind of avoid motorcycles and all the obstacles and really, really good. But I'm kind of scared of speed.
Maybe you can drive to the Azafueras and then Mark can drive.
Now he wants to drive because since he found out that I'm a bit, you know, like this, not much
right.
experience in the highway, I think he's a bit scared. So I don't know if he's going to let me. I'm going to have to insist somehow.
Yeah. Definitely. You can hold against him that he's a New Yorker, and what does he know about driving through Spain?
I'd be like, look, New Yorkers walk. You know. What about yourself?
I love driving. I'm a very fast driver.
Really?
Yeah. So I don't want to...
Freak Maria.
But if he wants to, I'm very, you know, I'm relaxed about it.
Easy going.
As long as I'm not sitting in the back going backwards, I'm fine in the car.
Good.
Driving backwards is not
it's
my
horrible.
Thing. I barf the whole, in 2 seconds.
What about in London?
The first sort of 6 months that I drove, I had to be very aware of everything. But after then, now it's completely like driving. I can be on either side of the road. I don't think about it.
Oh, wow.
The only thing that still happens to me is when I'm walking to my car in either country, I don't know what side the steering wheel's on.
Yeah, exactly.
Which
You're gonna
is
go in.
Embarrassing if there's paparazzi.
following me. I'm like walking to the car like, oh.
What side was it?
Circling my car like, oh, I always do this. What side is the wheel on? But after I get past that, then I'm fine.
Then you're good.
Yeah.
¿Estos en México cómo se llaman?
Estos se llaman berberecho.
These are the ones. A ver. Vinny, this is berberechos. These are going to change your life, my friend. This is the greatest single thing I've discovered in the last 5 years. This is like a cross between a scallop and a clam, and when they're just barely open, they are unbelievable.
We're going over to Galicia.
We're
going to
go see where they come from exactly. In fact, Gwyneth will forget what churros are when she tastes one of these.
That will be an achievement.
Are you ready to go?
I'm ready.
All right.
You?
I'm ready.
Vámonos.
Pues vámonos, ¿no?
Sí.
Hay mucho que ver.
Claro, ¿estás preparada?
Yo sí, ¿y tú?
También.
Me voy al servicio.
Venga, vámonos.
Some swordfish, my friend.
Dude, have you ever ridden a Harley? This is the Harley of the giant fish.
The beauty.
Well, it's getting a little late. I'm sure the ladies are just about done with their chocolate. Biddy, you gotta control the wheel.
Mario, enough.
Enough?
You worry about yourself. I'm going to take care of everything.
All right. Well, I think we should head down to Castilla-La Mancha, check out the world there. We're going to probably split up for a little while. Hold up your end of the deal, baby.
I'm going to be tilting at windmills.
I love that. That's a great thing.
Crazy. Wow, look at that cathedral. So when did they start building it? 13
and
until 1800. Isn't that crazy? You could start building a building that even your great
it's longer great, than great America's been alive. Who would even think it would be worth it to start? Let's start something that's going to take 500 years.
Well, they probably didn't know that it would take 500 years, would they?
I imagine they knew it would be a couple generations at least.
Yeah.
Stick-to-itiveness.
There you go.
Me la robo, me la llevo nuevo.
Claudia, how do we say estamos en La Mancha?
You said it perfectly.
Hey, we're in La Mancha.
Estamos en La Mancha.
But since we're in La Mancha,
yeah,
we have to sing from Hombre,
yeah,
de La Mancha.
Venga. Do you know?
Not very well.
Okay, well, you start it.
Sueñar. Un sueño imposible, luchar, un enemigo invencible. Not bad.
Invencible.
Invencible.
Invencible. Ah, mira, el río.
Ella se queda a mi lado, te guste o no te guste.
Rapids over there. Looks like maybe a little waterfall.
Sí.
Those houses, that's the smart house to have. That's the house.
Exactamente en el río, al lado del río.
With Gogo Paltrow at the wheel, we motored out to a place the locals refer to as the Cigarrales, the gardens and vineyards that overlook Toledo and the Rio Tajo. We were on our way to catch up with the chef of Toledo, a cool, slightly wired dude named Adolfo Muñoz. Adolfo was going to teach us a few traditional dishes of Castilla-La Mancha. Gwyneth wanted to learn how to make rice in the local fashion and a dish called pisto manchego, made from roasted vegetables. For the main course, Adolfo was going to cook perdiz, or partridge, two ways. Me, when it comes to food, I'm always game for anything. So when Adolfo would later offer me the equivalent of perdiz sushi, without blinking, I was in. Little did I know at that point that I was in immediate danger of hitting the end of the road just as we were setting out on the road.
So here we're gonna start, we're gonna take a little water, we're gonna infuse the saffron, and that's gonna be all the saffron we use for the rice.
Ahora el arroz, que sería lo que haríamos todo.
¿Y qué tipo de arroz es?
Este es un tipo de arroz español bomba. Es una no es una marca, es una variedad de arroz.
It's called que, bomba.
Que
sí.
Viene, que,
la bomba.
Que viene,
like you.
Sí.
He said before that if they put in olive oil, it covers the grain.
Yeah.
And
le echamos seco.
Vai. We're in Spain, okay?
Échalo.
He said he doesn't put anything except the saffron and the broth.
Y ahora ya, volviéndolo poco a poco.
Ah,
I've never seen it done like that.
Well, exactly.
All right, good. All right, so we have rice and saffron. Mm-hmm. Is it precious?
No, they don't say it like that here. It's like beautiful.
Okay, what kind of broth is that?
Es un caldo de verduras, por favor.
¿Todo?
Todo eso, es todo eso. Todo eso lo vamos a ir echando, efectivamente. Y ahora movemos de nuevo, muevo yo. Y vamos a dejar que se vaya el cociendo poco a poco.
This looks a lot like a risotto.
De alguna manera que vaya absorbiendo.
Sí.
It does look a lot like a risotto, though. Come on, tell me the truth.
We're not in Italy, okay? Let it go. Let it go. We're in Spain.
But do you dispute the fact that it looks a little risotto-esque?
Well, we're missing... No, because there's no oil.
There was no sofrito. It was an entirely radical different thing. But they are adding bit by bit just to catch on. All right, just wanted to make sure that that was for the record.
It's not lost on me.
Okay.
Bueno, podemos echar ya un poquito de verduras.
Sí.
Sí, sí, no importa.
Zanahoria.
Zanahoria, por ejemplo. Muy bien, perfecto, sí. Okay, muy bien.
We're putting in a handful of carrots.
And then?
Mmm. And then a little red pepper.
Sweet.
Sí.
Con dulces, no, no picantes.
Sí,
no,
pimiento no pica. Dulce. Pimiento dulce, además pimiento rojo más dulce.
Nada en España pica mucho.
No, really.
Es verdad.
Okay, I believe you.
Te lo
y ahora
juro.
Vamos a añadir. Sí, no voy a decir.
Wow.
Now you got a full boil going on there.
Yeah, baby.
Un poquito de nabo.
Nabo is turnip. Ahora echamos un poquito más del
caldo.
O dejamos cocinar?
Un poquito de caldo y ya lo dejamos cocinar ahí tranquilamente.
I've seen this somewhere.
Esto ya lo vamos a ir ahí.
I've never known how to do this.
Okay, now we're going to start another dish. This is a dish called pisto manchego. So I have two eggplants, I have two plum tomatoes, I have an onion and some peppers. Roasted in the oven.
Sal?
Perfecto. No, no sal.
Nothing.
Sal solamente le vamos a añadir al final.
Okay.
Le vas a
right, so after we pass this all like so. Okay.
It looks like
here's
that.
What you get.
Ahora es cuando añadiríamos el aceite.
Okay.
Es un aceite de cornicabra.
I would go about like.
Okay.
Let's see.
Okay.
Lo movemos. Entonces, y ahora.
This would be really good on a bruschetta, wouldn't it?
No. A little olive oil.
Ahora, míralo.
Ah. Well, bon appetito, chef.
Thank you.
That's right.
Mm-mm-mm.
Perfect. Got a 10 going on here, don't we?
We're going to avoid the main roads because we're not in a hurry.
Okay, you sure you know what you're doing?
Plus time for today's Spanish lesson. No, I have no idea where I'm going.
Okay, well...
What I need to know is not only in Espanol, but in several other languages.
What do you want to know?
How to say, I'm so hungry, I could eat a car.
Tengo tanta hambre que me comería un coche.
Un coche.
Yeah. Catalan.
Catalan.
Yeah.
Very exciting.
Ting.
Ting.
Tanta gana.
Tanta.
Gana.
Gana.
Que mangiaría.
Mangiaría. It's like French, Spanish, and Italian all in one language.
I know. Que mangiaría un coche.
Que mangiaría un coche.
Yeah, cool.
Ahora.
Ahora vamos a hacer la perdiz.
La perdiz. There's going to be two ways. He's going to show us the two ways that he's going to cook it. So, the broth is made with the bones. He's taking the breast off, but he's leaving the leg on the bone. So you have two kind of preparations, which makes it taste a little bit like the full spectrum. So will you eat a bird like this?
I'll eat a bird that lived a good life and was hunted from the wild.
This is good, right?
This is
good. This is clean and natural from the campo, right?
It had a nice, happy life until
Now. And it will continue its happy life in our tummies.
I don't believe in factory farming of any kind.
Excellent.
And I won't support it.
Good. Nor will we.
All right.
We don't have to when we're here.
No.
Ahora, chef, ¿qué hacemos?
Pues vamos a poner las pechugas.
Sí.
Las vamos a poner un poquito a la parrilla.
Beautiful.
Las dos. Vamos a untarlas un poquito con aceite de oliva.
Olive oil.
Muy poquito. Simplemente para que no se peguen.
Ah.
Okay.
The painting trick. That was
very good.
Muy poquito,
A little dip.
I learned something
every
day.
And then paint the actual grill. Ay, chef.
Ahí está.
Okay.
Y ahora,
las piernitas
esto,
así.
Y esto lo que vamos a hacer es la vamos a poner con la salsa para que durante 30 a 35 minutos hiervan y estén cocidas. Y más salsa la ponemos y así va, coge más sabor todavía.
Muy bien.
So the legs have gone in this kind of reduced gravy sauce broth thing, and they're going to cook for 35 minutes like that. And here we're flipping the little breasts of these partridge.
Partridge. Entonces yo siempre procuro dejarlas así, que estén un poquito crudas para que saber lo que estamos comiendo perfectamente.
Okay, so porque es muy, a little on the rare side.
Es muy importante. Bueno,
she's
no.
She's going to prefer them to be cooked.
Por eso vamos
pretty much
a
guarantee it.
¿Eh? Nosotros, so if you eat it a little bit raw, he says you've got the taste of the country and the bird and its history and where it came
from. And the field and the trees and the wind, the way it blows and the way it smells on a Saturday afternoon when you're out hunting with all your buddies.
Eso.
La podemos sacar ya.
¿Ya?
He thinks it's done when it's raw.
He thinks it's done.
It's okay.
Así crudo.
Así crudo.
No, así, así, así. No está crudo. Está.
It's not raw.
Está perfecto. Está muy
it's
bien.
It's perfect.
Está perfecto. Muy bien. ¿Ves?
Okay.
Está perfecto. Vamos a hacerlo ahora. Le vamos a hacer para
yo
que...
Yo no puedo comerlo así, tan
no,
crudo.
No, pero no, te vamos a dar el trocito. Bueno, vamos a hacerle... Entonces, si le queremos menos crudo, lo que haríamos es esta operación.
Sí.
Hacemos esta operación. Entonces ahora ponemos otro poquito a la plancha.
Ah, muchísimas gracias.
Entonces se pueden hacer de diferentes maneras. Es decir, lo que vamos a hacer es sencillamente una.
Muy bien.
So for the well done crab, this is called butterflying the stick.
Y ya le ponemos.
And Mario can eat that one.
Se puede tomar de varias maneras.
Sí.
Perfectamente.
Él es muy valiente. Puede comer cualquier cosa. Yo menos.
Valiente.
Mucho.
También
las piernitas. I'm down with that.
I'm down with it.
Look how tender it is.
It's like my grandmother's brisket.
Vamos a poner dos platos.
It's like your grandma's brisket, except the breast is raw.
Ahora vamos a picar
the lavender, the pepper, the onions, all the ingredients from the braising liquid that the legs went in are going to go on raw at the last minute here.
I love that.
And that gives you all that full
That's
flavor.
That's lovely. Look at that.
Ahí.
Ah, now's the salt.
Un poquito de sal.
See, I like that little rock salt on the
I
end.
Love it.
It's okay.
I love it.
Y ya por último, el aceite de oliva.
There you go.
El jugo.
The gravy is actually the olive oil.
Eso es.
Oh, he goes right at it. That's beautiful.
I like it.
Eso es.
Smell that oil.
Una hojita de laurel que la hemos echado antes para decorar.
Increíble. You're going to have the pretty sushi.
The sushi.
Y yo.
The well done roast beef. Para Mario.
Le vamos a dar.
Wow.
Look at the medium rare.
¿Quieres un trocito más?
Sí, por favor.
La cebolla también, ¿no?
Is there an elegant way to eat this?
Oye, mira, un plato. Mira qué plato más bonito. Este es un plato perfecto. No, ese plato es perfecto.
Mi madre me va a matar.
No.
Cinco.
Hombre.
One, two. Hold on. See the hand? Oh, that is.
I tell
that is
you.
Beautiful. That's attractive for me. That's hot. That works.
Please.
El arroz?
Bueno, vamos al arroz que.
Vale.
Las setas.
I'm going to be very judicious with my setas.
Careful.
Okay. So I don't get pounded by the chef.
He said you like mushrooms too, huh? I guess no. I think that's enough.
It's okay.
No, it's okay.
Bueno, es que
la cocinera.
You're the
okay, entonces me voy a poner
más
porque me encanta. ¿Y?
Too many chefs, you know.
Eso menos. Smelling really.
Aceite de oliva virgen. Ahora es cuando echamos al final.
I knew this was going to sneak in.
Ahora es cuando echamos al final. Perfecto. Sencillamente, un platito de arroz. Y ahora ya, pues sí, lo que tenemos que añadirle también, que siempre, son algunas hierbas. Prácticamente se evitará mucho.
Y
un poquito de
rosemary.
Y sencillamente la sal. Ahora sí la sal. Y ahora probamos.
Ladies first.
Oh, well, thanks. God, that lavender smells
so good. Oh, heady.
Lo que tiene todo sabor.
That's really, really beautiful.
See, with the salt, it's unbelievable.
And the thyme and the lavender.
That's spectacular. I have one thing to say to you.
What?
Holy Toledo. That's funny.
That's so
funny.
Wrong.
It's so funny.
That it's right.
That's funny. I'm going to eat all the salt right here on the top.
That's okay, there's more.
Meanwhile, Biddy and Besoles were about an hour outside of Toledo in a tiny town called Tembleque. They were hunting down another Castilla-La Mancha treasure, queso manchego.
Claudia, how do we say, I love the sky?
Me encanta el cielo.
I love the land.
Me gusta la tierra.
El vino.
Yeah, you know that one quite well.
The food, comida.
Comida.
The people, gente.
Yeah.
And most of all.
Y sobre todo. It's important to punch your leg.
Sobre
in the
todo, yeah. El queso manchego.
Oh, I love it.
Yeah.
Alfonso Alvarez, the cheesemaker at Arte Queso, is a marathon runner who looks like he stepped straight out of the pages of GQ. But he makes one of the best artisanal manchegos in Spain. And that begins, of course, with the milk. Claudia, ever the animal lover, would undoubtedly get up close and personal with some of Alfonso's 1,200 sheep.
I don't think she's liking this. Perdón, un momento más.
Keep at it. You're a cheesemaker now.
Oh, wow, how exciting. I've never been to a cheesery before. Es que nunca he estado en una quesería antes.
¿Y te gusta?
Me encanta.
You're excited, huh?
Of course.
I've done this like 50 times.
Oh, come on, Vivendi, I'm so jaded.
The process is very similar from one to the next of the good cheese-making places.
Yeah, but
here you have such great milk. The sheep are so beautiful.
There you go.
The process is really good. This manchego is like the Parmesan in Spain. It's really,
dice que este
really
manchego
the top,
es el parmesano
the top cheese.
De España, que es el lo más que sí. Hay en queso, es verdad,
verdad,
¿no?
Es verdad. El queso manchego es el referente de queso español.
He says that it's the reference of Spanish cheese.
The queen.
No doubt. The queen and king and everything, ¿no?
The boss.
The boss.
So, what do we do?
¿Qué hacemos?
Simplemente, esto realmente es como una cacerola grande.
It's just like a big casserole. So this warms up the milk.
¿Sí? Start at 4, which is about 40.
Oh, okay,
38
yeah.
Or 40 Fahrenheit, and
yeah.
Then it's warmed up to...
¿Hasta cuánto se calienta?
Hasta 31 grados.
31,
so
es
85.
Es el momento de cuajado.
Guajara must mean a curd.
Yeah,
and curdle is what we say things...
Okay, curd.
And then... It comes in here, it curdles, and then there's the knives in here, chop it up.
Yeah. They cut the cuajada to the size of approximately a chickpea. One of the secrets to make the really good manchego cheese is to get a cuajada that is very much like into bits.
Small, like
yeah.
You said, pea size.
Yeah, that's muy importante. The next step is the when we fill the containers, and that process has a lot more noise. Watching the process of filling a manchego cheese. The second step seals it so there's no holes left and the air cannot go through it.
Yeah, it will be pressed, I
exactly,
think.
Exactly,
yeah?
Pressed, yeah. Oye, a mí esto me recuerda mucho a un sketch de, ¿tú sabes Lucille Ball?
¿Lo qué?
Lucille Ball, aquella que hacía unos sketches cómicos y había uno en el que estaba trabajando.
In the factory?
Yeah, and I want to kind of do something like that.
Yeah, but I'm highly skilled.
Oh,
this
on.
Is not good enough. There will be no mistakes here.
Come on.
Once I put the gloves on,
well, we'll see about
like
that.
A surgeon.
Yeah, right.
Entonces, para que veáis, cógelo ahora.
Yo, ¿esto?
Okay. El molde, para arriba. Esta es la identificación.
Ah, this is the label that differentiates a real manchego from one that's not.
Aquí podemos ver la palabra manchego
yeah.
Y un código de 5 números y 2 letras.
Here we can see the word manchego and a code of numbers and 2 letters.
And DOC, manchego.
Yeah.
Todo.
It's a bit like the lottery. This is a...
No, they're consecutive. It's not like the lottery.
Ahora el queso está sin prensar, está todo lleno de agujeros. Pero por eso ahora lo prensamos.
Claro, this one is the one that's still...
Cuidado, déjalo que te pese.
Sí. Okay, now we're gonna get to do the real deal. Are you up to it? Let's see who wins.
Wins?
Yeah.
Con la mano.
Competition.
Con la mano. Yes. Muy bien.
Perfecto.
Hey, look at this.
Nice, huh?
Yo te levanto.
Now what?
Now you have to stick it back in. Ahora qué?
No tengas miedo.
Yes.
Oh, it's really great here. I love Spain.
Living on the water, do a little fishing every morning. Hike up the hill to get your calabazas and your...
Hierba buena.
Hierba buena. Your bomba arroz. Wonder how long there's been a road right here.
Imagino siglos, no? Siglos.
Centuries.
What a noise.
I know. So we've had them in the containers for already 6 to 7 hours. The pH is perfect, so now it's the moment to
put them... And they have been prensada.
Exacto. So it's the moment to put them in the brine.
So I think I'm going to hear that sound now in my sleep, that...
Dice que cree que va a escuchar ese ruido en sus sueños.
Sí, yo sí los escucho.
Yeah, yeah. 300 times a day is enough. So now... What happens?
The cheeses that we've removed with the noise, we're gonna put them inside now in the brine.
In the cage. They go in a little cage.
Yeah, to go here.
And this is what percentage salt?
More salted than seawater.
Say goodbye to them, my darling.
Goodbye, manchegos. Ooh.
This is like Houdini.
You think
you know? Can you get out?
Ooh. The 300 kilogram cheese remains 24 hours in this.
Y el queso pequeño lo dejamos 16 horas.
And the small one, 16 hours.
16 for the small ones, 24 for the big
yeah.
one.
And then?
Y,
bueno,
y luego,
y después,
lo último,
ahora lo que habéis visto del proceso del queso manchego es el primer día de fabricación.
This is the first day of manufacturing the queso manchego, what we've seen so far.
Aquí están otro día más, 24 horas.
Here there's another day.
Es el segundo día de vida de un queso.
Second day of life of a cheese, I love that.
Y hasta los 3, 4, 5 meses de donde está preparado para el consumo, estarán wow. en las cámaras de maduración.
Until the 3, 4, or 5 months that it requires for it to be ready to be eaten, it's going to be in the, you don't call it chambers, do you?
What cellar.
You call it? Cellars.
Cheese cave.
Yeah, exactly. The cheese cave. I like
yeah.
it.
Aging room.
Cool.
¿Queréis probarle?
Sí.
Vamos a probarlo. Venga. Para cortarlo, el ideal es hacerlo por detrás para no arrastrar el papel de la etiqueta a lo largo del queso.
It's better to cut it, turn, flipping it around so that you don't drag the paper all the time while you're cutting your cheese.
Sí.
They think of everything,
yeah.
huh? It's a very hard cheese because it's 16 months old.
Yeah.
You need a strong knife and a strong person.
Like me.
Go ahead.
That's, he said that actually.
¿Quieres probar?
Sí. Pero si
Let your fingers out of the way.
No te preocupes.
No.
Tienes que apoyar. Mira, déjame.
Creo
tienes,
que sí.
Tienes
así.
Que poner esto fuerte
¿Sí?
y aquí,
Tengo
con todas tus fuerzas, apretar, okay. ¿vale?
Easy peasy.
Rock it back
Muy
and
bien.
Forth.
Let's go. ¿Puedo cortarlo a cualquier lado?
Sí,
sí.
Es, da igual.
Venga, ¿eh? Okay, here we go.
Con ganas.
Look, I'm
es el queso
there.
Más that's difícil that. De cortar.
It's the hardest cheese to cut. That's
sí.
something that you really need to know. Okay, here we go.
You've had a hard day milking sheep, cutting
si,
hard cheeses.
Si
be
quieres,
careful. Be
si
careful.
Termino,
oh, incredible.
Voy a terminarlo.
A ver, he's just gonna finish the easy bit.
Ahora, mira, lo importante es más vale maña que fuerza.
Yeah,
¿eh?
Es verdad.
Mira.
You know that saying? Más vale maña que fuerza. It's more important to have
ya está
know-how
cortado, y ahora,
than strength. Wow. You know what I mean?
Para cortar la etiqueta.
Oh.
Beautiful.
Amazing, eh?
Wow.
The
color.
No es el mejor queso.
Oh, pero huele increíble, ¿eh?
smells unbelievable.
It's incredible. I love it. Yeah.
And the color, it's this sort of beautiful pearly alabaster white.
And the smellier, the better. I love it.
Alabaster, I think.
I think I'm like, you know the Proud Love dog? I'm already starting to...
Siempre es bueno cortar. ¿Este para quién?
¿A quién se va a quedar primero? No.
No, a ti te voy a dar el semicurado.
Why me?
Ah, pero ¿por qué? ¿Por qué le das este a él?
Hombre, porque lo normal es el queso más curado para la persona más mayor y el queso...
He's very gently saying that this one is for older people, and then...
How did he know?
For young. I don't know.
Sí, sí.
Claro. Do you like it?
Yeah, it's great.
Aunque seguro que a ti te gusta mucho también el curado. Ya dice mucho, ya dice mucho.
He says, but it says a lot already. I like that.
It's beautiful.
So happy. Did you see them?
Oh, isn't that nice? That makes me feel good.
Never understood the shriek response, though.
Because, you know what? It's sort of like...
Maximum expression?
Well, you know, the Spanish are passionate.
That was passionate.
I would shriek if I saw you walking down the street and I didn't know you.
Not.
I would. I would go, oh, my God, it's Brian Vitale. I would.
Yeah, but there's a difference between, oh, my God, it's Brian Vitale. The Beatles thing. Bono gets this kind of stuff all the time, too, babe. Don't worry about it.
Bono gets what stuff?
You know, police escorts.
But he's Bono.
And you're Gweenie. Gweenie.
And I'm just a overeating
just
mother,
a
too.
Overeating housewife from England.
That's true. I do it
what
well.
What do you suppose Bittman's doing all day?
Yeah, where is he?
How come they don't do nothing?
Who do you think it would be, El Quijote or Sancho Panza?
With you?
Yeah.
El Quijote.
Really?
Yeah, because you are little and fat and...
No, but I am... You're the realist.
I am a realist.
I think,
you're
right?
The idealist?
Yeah, maybe.
Like when I said, oh, look how beautiful it is, except for this oil factory
yeah, exactly.
in front of it. Yes.
And instead, I don't even see them. I was blind to them.
Blind to anything ugly. That's you.
Exactly. There you go.
You see things only beautifully.
Well, that's... I like Quixote. He's nuts, but he's happy. You know what I mean?
That's one of your lovers in the background.
Hey, Mario.
Hey, how you doing?
All right. You got one.
One.
You got one.
One for Vitale, 14,000 for Paltrow. This is San Tomé.
Okay.
This is where our church, the burial of the Count of Orgaz. I look like a rock star. Perfect parking job.
Look at all these guys.
Look at them. So, the first time I came here with my family.
Yeah.
As we're coming up the steps, a family's walking out, and they say to me, y'all don't need to come in there, there's only one painting. My mom turned purple.
Oh my gosh, that's hilarious.
And thus started my first visit with El Conde de Orgaz. Well, that's a famous one. El Entierro del Conde de Orgaz.
It's amazing. There's so much happening.
We came here probably the first time when I was 16. And this was one of the crucial points. We left Toledo anyway, gastronomically as well.
Was the painting ever explained to you?
Yeah, I mean, my mom has always been kind of an explainer of sorts. So this is the burial as seen 250 years after the burial of the dude. The Conde of Orgaz, who was in fact not a count. And they're bringing his body, and suddenly two saints appear. And that's a picture of El Greco, the seventh guy, and there's all kinds of interesting numerology, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The one who's looking directly at us with the really bright face, that's El Greco.
The fact that El Greco is the 7th guy in, and certain imagery in the painting makes me think that El Greco maybe studied the Kabbalah.
You mean that was the Kabbalah before Madonna?
A long time before Madonna.
Yeah. I thought she invented that stuff about the Powerade. I think the sources of light is probably the thing that gets me the most.
I think that the use of light is symbolic. Or maybe everybody's getting the light that they deserve.
Ah. The justice of the approach to heaven. It means you get your own scene, your own makeup person.
No, it means if you're connected to God, then you maybe get more light reflected upon you.
Well, so much for the spiritual world of the 1500s in Spain. Are you hungry?
You know me.
I've got a recipe for raw partridge. You out.
They built these things, I think they're 700 years old.
Yeah, like amazing.
600 years old.
Maybe we should move to the Molinos.
Ooh. Mira. Ah.
Wow, this is amazing.
You could live up on top.
Yeah, right? It would be the great spot.
Are you proposing?
Yeah.
Finally.
I can visit you and bring fruit. Once a month, bring you a whole stock of it.
Claudia, the romantic, was ready to tilt a few windmills, but I knew by now that Bittman would be hungry and have eating on his mind. Javier Muñoz, Adolfo's son, was poised to sate Bitty's needs. You don't grow up as son of Adolfo without knowing how to cook another local dish called migas, something akin to American turkey stuffing on steroids, spiked with chorizo and ungodly amounts of olive oil.
So, Claudia, we're here with Javier, dressed like I don't know what. What are we dressed like,
really
Manchegans?
Special.
Yes, like Sancho Panza dressing.
Yeah, here we go.
There you go.
Es muy cómodo para trabajar, además.
Very comfortable to work in.
Y luego nosotros normalmente lo llevamos en el cuello, pero Mark lo lleva en la cabeza porque
usually, normal people wear it in the neck, but you decided to go for the more radical look.
I had to keep my hair back.
Yeah. Okay.
So, we're cooking, I assume?
Vamos a hacer unas migas manchegas, pan y vino. Para andar el camino.
Pan y vino para andar el camino. O sea, bread and wine to walk along the way. But in English it doesn't work.
Tenemos aquí primero ponemos un poquito de aceite.
O sea, first a little bit of olive oil.
Un poquito. Entonces, ahora vamos a poner los ajos.
Now the garlic.
Únicamente para rehogarlos.
Con la piel, ¿eh?
Eso es, con la piel.
With the skin, yeah.
Y utilizamos una cucharita para que se rehoguen.
Just stir it like that.
Una vez terminamos de rehogar los ajitos, look at the smell.
Yeah, it's beautiful. I'm ready to eat it already.
Son ajos de las pedronieras en Cuenca. Dicen que son los mejores ajos del mundo.
They say they're the best garlic in the world from Cuenca.
Where do they say this, in Cuenca?
No, in all over the world.
Everywhere in the world, yes. It's known that the best garlic is from Cuenca?
Vienes exclusivamente a Cuenca para por los ajos.
A por los ajos.
You know, the chauvinism people have for their own places is just unbelievable.
No, pero es cierto.
I'm sure it's very good garlic.
Ahora estás es chorizo
y panceta.
Panceta.
Esto era para darle un poquito de más alimento al pan.
To give a bit more of nourishment.
Para las migas.
I would say so. A little bit more nourishment.
Quite a lot, actually.
Well, we are 25, ¿no? Entonces, ahora ya vamos viendo el punto que se están poniendo tostaditos todo.
We start to see that it's getting them a bit, how do you say,
crisp?
Yeah. The ingredients are thanking us for treating them so well.
Oh, that's beautiful, Javier.
Y luego le agradeceremos nosotros de que se porten bien con nosotros.
And then we will be grateful that they are being so kind to us.
And in return, we will eat them.
Yeah,
exactly.
Entonces, aquí tenemos las migas.
Claudia. Sí. Ve cogiendo un poquito, no, coge.
Ah, con,
ve cogiendo con las manos, no, con tus manos.
Con las manos.
Esas preciosas manos que tienes.
Manos.
Bueno, no, pero un poquito más bajo.
I'm serious, come on.
Que si no, tiene que.
This is great.
Ya un poquito.
¿Más?
Sí, un poquito más.
I love this.
Yo creo que vamos a tener. Ah, ¿qué?
It's like being a kid.
I know.
Playing in sand.
Y otra vez. A mover.
And then, once again,
y tienen que estar doraditas.
They need to be golden. So,
y que se mezclen bien con la panceta.
Oh, look, they're already done.
And to mix them well. Ooh, look at that.
Ya veis que se están poniendo doraditas.
They're already starting to be golden, crispy and nice.
Como el sol de Toledo.
Like the sun of Toledo. He's a poet,
he
really.
A poet. He's
and
unbelievable.
He cooks on the side.
Ay,
you're working very hard.
Yo sé que estás trabajando muy duro, ¿eh?
Es la única forma de que salgan bien las cosas.
The only way that things turn out well. I think you should spend a week with Javier.
I know, I could learn how to speak.
I think it would be great.
No,
Mar ya lo sabe suficiente. Mar ya conoce.
The kid's like a genius.
Yeah, I know. He wants you to try it, to be the judge.
Pero un poquito aquí. Un poquito de uvas.
Uvas.
Anda, y pimientos.
The uvas is typical?
Sí. Let's taste.
You're the taste judge.
I can smell it, it's wonderful. But I'm happy to eat it.
¿Y pimiento también se pone siempre? ¿Qué tal, you like?
¿Qué tal, I like?
Well, yummy.
So many cultures have this, it's like fried rice.
Yo creo que muchas culturas, gracias, tienen este, es como el arroz frito.
Era comida para pobres. Al pan no le puedes pedir mucho más. Lo que tienes que intentar.
You can't ask much more from bread.
No, you can't.
Really, you can't.
Well, you give it chorizo, it responds.
No. I told you.
Hombre, que viene. Les tenemos que ofrecer algo de comer.
Hace tanto tiempo que no como que ya no me acuerdo si los platos son redondos o cuadrados.
Buenas tardes.
¿A qué se debe este agasajo?
Buenas tardes.
¿Puedo darle a estos chicos un poco?
Le
vamos a dar un poco, ¿no? Porque está un poco alterado, yo creo. Le ayudará. Un minutito y come. Aparte está muy bueno.
Come un poco, Sancho. Pues si fuera. Pero come con orden, por Dios, que lo que a ti te atañe a mí me incumbe y nos van a llevar mendigos como poco. Pero dígame, señor, ¿son pastores por ventura? ¿Están aquí en la esposura de este bosque?
¿Me las puedo llevar todas?
Claro. Ahí están ricas.
Están buenísimas.
Mira qué bien lo hace. A ver, ¿qué
quieres?
Hay que seguir los consejos de buen capuchino. Hagan lo que hagan, un buen trago vino.
Sancho, ya estás tardando en agradecer a esta buena gente.
As Sancho and Don Q sauntered off into the sunset, Biddy and Basoles had to hightail it as well. We were celebrating the young Basoles' birthday that evening, and it would be nightfall by the time they made it to Toledo.
So, look where we are.
Oh my God, it's beautiful.
It's spectacular. Toledo, unbelievable.
Wow.
You've been here before?
No.
Of course not.
You have, right?
Yes. But you don't travel in your own country.
No. I'm very ashamed of this, actually. But I mean, it's never too late to begin, I think, so.
You know why we're here?
Why?
Because you said it's your birthday! Da 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 da.
Yeah, I get it. Thanks. But control yourself now, huh?
I could sing happy birthday also.
Oh, no, it's okay. Thanks for the attention is what counts.
Anyway, I'm taking you to this unbelievable place up this hill.
Yeah.
Mario and Gwyneth are there.
Oh,
we hope Mario's been cooking with the chef Adolfo.
Ooh, I've heard he's amazing.
He's amazing.
And Mario is amazing, of course, so there you go.
And it's a really spectacular place where you're gonna have a great dinner.
Oh my God, I can't wait. It's great.
And you're what, 19 today, right?
Yeah, exactly. It's a great age to be, no?
No, it's a fabulous age.
I mean, you being 25, you have quite,
thank you,
quite thanks.
That evening, Adolfo and his family served us a knockdown, knockout dinner, all washed down with more than ample amounts of great vintage wines of every color and varietal.
You know what? When we move to the next color of wine, stop asking me what to translate.
What is the next color?
from white. When we went ahead, we had pink, then we had white, now we had red.
By the time it came to celebrate the young Claudia's birthday over dessert, none of us were feeling any pain. One brief postscript. Little did I know it during dinner, but later that evening I would revisit my partridge sushi experience, and in fact, revisit it over and over and over during a long night. No matter, iron chefs have iron stomachs and short memories.
Mm-hmm.
Next morning, as Gogo and I motored out of Toledo, I was ready and game to move on down the road.
When I see olive trees, suddenly I get very excited.
And then you make your friends eat them raw. And your bout of food poisoning last night is payback for making me eat a raw olive off the tree.
It was. But you know, it was one of the best lessons we'll both ever learn.
Yes. No raw olives, no raw partridge.
No raw partridge.
Out, babies. I like the solidity of those doors. Good morning.
Good
nice
morning.
Time.
How are you?
Good. Goodbye. Bye. Have a great trip.
Thank you. I'm
going to see you in 5 seconds.
Yes, you are.
So,
where are you going?
I'm going home to be with my kids. I can't take it anymore.
That's
as much
sweet.
As I love the three of you.
And us?
They could come here.
Yeah, but I don't want to schlep them around and exploit them on camera. Where are you guys going to go?
Ribera.
Avila.
And we'll see you in Galicia.
Okay.
Cool vibes.
Don't eat anything good without me. Only eat raw pheasant.
Raw pheasant, raw quail, drive safely.
Thanks. Later, skaters!
I like that.
Bob knows how to travel.
Okay.
Pull the thing all the way back.
Great, right?
You're good.
I've never driven automatic before.
Oh, I feel great driving with it.
How do I pull this?
Push your brakes.
Discussion.
Oh.
How great a driver you are. There you go.
I have an idea.
Okay.
What do you think about doing an Iron Chef here with us in Spain? You and me.
Me and you on the same team?
Yeah.
Versus
Bittman and Claudia.
A crush.
We'd smoke them.
Manic depression.
I know.
Just gotta say.
When did you see me depressed?
Bittman, I've known you for 10 years. All right, we're in Galicia, baby. Galicia is an amazing place. Probably most famous from the chef's perspective. Putting you to sleep. It became a place as opposed to Rome for Christians to come to pay their respects. This is on the same level as St. Peter.
Why are you yelling at me?
Because I'm so excited.
What did I do to you?
Want to know more about our most excellent road trip through Spain? For killer recipes, blog updates, travel tips, and a few wacky things we didn't show you on TV, visit us at SpainOnTheRoadAgain.com.
Relive every episode with Spain, A Culinary Road Trip, the companion cookbook and travel guide. Mario chronicles an eating tour like no other with Gwyneth, Mark, and Claudia on the Spanish road trip of a lifetime. The volume features hundreds of striking color photos and more than 70 regional recipes. You can order by visiting SpainOnTheRoadAgain.com or call 800-260-8633. The price is $34.95. And remember, what happened in Spain didn't stay in Spain.
On the road again, just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again, going places that I've never been, seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again.